This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Colloquial Singaporean English, better known as Singlish, is an English-based creole language spoken in Singapore. While English is one of Singapore's official languages, Singlish is commonly regarded as having low prestige. The Singaporean government and some Singaporeans alike heavily discourage the use of Singlish in favor of standard English. The government has created an annual Speak Good English movement to emphasize the point. Singlish is also heavily discouraged in the mass media and in schools. However, such official discouragement and routine censorship is actually countered by other presentations in mainstream media, including routine usage by ordinary people in street interviews broadcast on TV and radio on a daily basis, as well as occasional usage in newspapers. The vocabulary of Singlish consists of words originating from English, Malay, Hokkien, Teochew, Cantonese, Tamil, and to a lesser extent various other European, Indic and Sinitic languages. Also, elements of American and Australian slang have come through from imported television series and films. Contents 1. Overview and History 2. Sociolect Continuum 21. Usage in Society 3. Phonology 31. Background 32. Consonants 33. Vowels 34. Tones 35. Prosody 4. Grammar 41. Topic Prominence 42. Nouns 43. To be 44. Past tense 45. Change of state 46. Negation 47. Interrogative 48. Reduplication 49. Discourse particles 410. Singlish phrases 4101. Kenna 4102 TO 4103 1 4104 then 4105 OI 4106 LA 4107 WAT 4108 MA 4109 LOR 41010 LAY 41011 HOR 41012 Arkansas 41013 HA 41014 ME 41015 SHIEL 41016 SIA 41017 Sai 41018 Shao 41019 Summary 411 Miscellaneous 5 Vocabulary 6 See also 7 Notes and References 8 Further Reading 9 External Links Overview and History Singapore English derives its roots from 146 years 1819-1965 of British colonial rule over Singapore prior to 1965. The standard form of English in Singapore had always been British English and received pronunciation after Singapore declared independence in 1965. English in Singapore began to take a life of its own, leading to the development of modern-day standard Singapore English. Standard Singapore English began to take root and Singlish began to evolve among the working classes who learned English without formal schooling. Singlish originated with the arrival of the British and the establishment of English language schools in Singapore. Soon, English filtered out of schools and onto the streets, to be picked up by non-English speakers in a pigeon-like form for communication purposes after some time. This new form of English, now loaded with substantial influences from Indian English, Baba, native Malay, and the southern varieties of Chinese, became the language of the streets and began to be learned as a first language in its own right. Creolization occurred, and Singlish is now a fully formed, stabilized, and independent English-based Creole language. Singlish shares many linguistic similarities with Manglish of Malaysia, although a few distinctions can be made, particularly in vocabulary. Manglish generally now receives more Malay influence and Singlish more Chinese Mandarin, Hokkien, etc. influence. Initially, Singlish and Manglish were essentially the same dialect evolving from the British Malaya economy, born in the trading ports of Singapore, Malacca and Penang when Singapore and Peninsular Malaysia were for many purposes a de facto single entity in Singapore. English was the language of administration, which the British used, with the assistance of English-educated Straits-born Chinese, to control the administration in Malaya and governance of trading routes such as the British East Indies spice routes with China, Japan, Europe and America in those ports and colonies of Singapore, Malacca and Penang through the colonial governing seat in Singapore in British Malaya. English was the language of the British administration, whilst Malay was spoken as the lingua franca of the streets, as the British did not wish to antagonize the native Malays in British Singapore. However, as the seat of the colonial government and international commerce, English was both the language of administration and the lingua franca. Citation needed. In Malaya, the Chinese varieties themselves also contained many loan words from Malay, and more Chinese loan words from the Hokkien, rather than the Cantonese. For example, Hokkien-influenced pa sat instead of the Cantonese-influenced ba sok in Singapore from Malay pasar meaning market, lodi from Malay roti meaning bread, Hokkien guli and jam bban from Malay guli meaning marble, and Malay jamban meaning toilet. Many signs in Singapore include all four official languages, English, Chinese, Tamil and Malay after Singapore's independence in 1965, and successive Speak Mandarin campaigns. A subtle language shift among the post-1965 generation became more and more evident as Malay idiomatic expressions were, and continued to be, displaced by idioms borrowed from Chinese spoken varieties, such as Hokkien sociolect continuum. The English language in Singapore is a sociolect continuum. The continuum runs through the following varieties: acrolectal. Acrolectal Singaporean English exhibits an absence of or a much smaller degree of Singlish pronunciation features than do mesolectal, basolectal, and pidgin variants of Singlish. Mesolectal, this is the most commonly spoken form of Singlish. It is a mix between Standard English and Singlish at this level. A number of features not found in other forms of English begin to emerge. Basolectal, this is the most colloquial form of speech here. One can find all of the unique phonological, lexical, and grammatical features of Singlish. Many of these features can be attributed to Asian languages such as Chinese, Malay, or Indian languages such as Tamil, though some cannot. Both the basolect and mesolect are referred to as Singlish pidgin. This is the pidgin level of Singlish, which is probably a good representative of an earlier stage of Singlish, before creolization took place and solidified Singlish as a fully formed creole. As with all pidgins, speakers at the pidgin level speak another language as a first language, and Singlish as a second language. However, since a substantial number of people today learn Singlish natively, the number of speakers at the pidgin level of Singlish is dwindling. This is because, by definition, a pidgin is not learned natively. The coexistence of basolectal Singlish and acrolectal Standard Singapore English can also be analyzed as a diglossia, which is a split between a high formal language and a low informal language, the sociolect continuum of Singaporean English. Each of the following means the same thing, but the basolectal and mesolectal versions incorporate some colloquial additions for illustrative purposes. Basolect Singlish dis guy Singlish si bay zai sia, mesolect dis guy Singlish damn good a. Acrolect Standard, this person's Singlish is very good. Since many Singaporeans can speak English at multiple points along the sociolect spectrum, code switching can occur very frequently between the acrolect Standard Singapore English and the mesolect Common Singlish. In addition, as many Singaporeans are also speakers of Chinese, Malay, or Indian languages such as Tamil, code switching between English and other languages also occurs dynamically. For example, a local Singaporean might speak in a Singlish consisting of English, Hokkien, Malay and Indian loan words. When chatting with his friends, usage in society, Singlish is commonly regarded with low prestige in Singapore. For this reason, Singlish is not used in formal communication. Standard Singapore English is preferred by many educated Singaporeans due to its origins. Singlish shares many similarities with pidgin varieties of English, and can easily give the impression of broken English or bad English to a speaker of some other, less divergent variety of English. In addition, the profusion of Singlish features, especially loanwords from Asian languages, mood particles, and topic prominent structure, can easily make Singlish incomprehensible to a speaker of Standard English. As a result, the use of Singlish is greatly frowned on by the government, and two former prime ministers, Lee Kuan Yew and Goh Chok Tong, have publicly declared that Singlish is a substandard English that handicaps Singaporeans, presents an obstacle to learning proper English, and renders the speaker incomprehensible to everyone except another Singlish speaker. Current Prime Minister Lee Hsien Loong has also said that Singlish should not be part of Singapore's identity in the interests of promoting equality and better communication with the rest of the world. In 2000, the government launched the Speak Good English movement to eradicate it, at least from formal usage. The Media Development Authority's free-to-air TV code states that the use of Singlish should not be encouraged and can only be permitted in interviews, where only the interviewee speaks Singlish. Despite this, in recent years the use of Singlish on television and radio has proliferated as localized Singlish continues to be popular among Singaporeans, especially in comedies. Singlish is strongly discouraged in Singaporean schools at a governmental level as it is believed to hinder the proper learning of Standard English, and so faces a situation of diglossia. The use of Singlish when speaking in classes or to teachers teachers, however officially frowned upon, is rather inevitable given that many teachers themselves are comfortable with the variety in most workplaces. Singlish is avoided in formal settings, especially at job interviews, meetings with clients, presentations or meetings. Standard Singapore English is preferred nevertheless. Select Singlish phrases are sometimes injected into discussions to build rapport or for a humorous effect, especially when the audience consists mainly of locals, but more recent Speak Good English campaigns are conducted with tacit acceptance of Singlish as a valid patois in informal settings, such as during conversation with friends, or transactions in kopitiams and shopping malls. Singlish is used without restriction for many students, using Singlish is inevitable when interacting with their peers, siblings, parents and elders. Singapore humor writer Sylvia Toh Paikchu was the first to put a spelling and a punctuation to Singlish in her books A Gundu 1982 and Laji Gundu 1986, which are essentially a glossary of Singlish, which she terms Pasar Patois phonology background. This section does not cite any sources. Please help improve this section by adding citations to reliable sources. Unsourced material may be challenged and removed. October 2008. Learn how and when to remove this template message. Singlish pronunciation, while built on a base of British English, is heavily influenced by native Malay, Hokkien and Cantonese. There are variations within Singlish, both geographically and ethnically. Chinese, native Malays, Indians, Eurasians, and other ethnic groups in Singapore all have distinct accents. All of these communities were formed by the earliest immigrants to Singapore and thus have been British subjects for three or more generations. Thus, they have received no other native education than solely British colonial education, especially for those born before 1960. All the education received has been direct English rather than British influences. Many of the East Coast communities were descendants or in other ways, privileged to be granted British colonial education similar to those in Britain. As such, the acrolectal standard of English does not diverge substantially from the acrolectal standard in Britain at this time, though as in other colonial outposts it always tended to be somewhat out of date compared with contemporary speech patterns in Britain. The English educated in Singapore received their English pedagogical instruction through missionary schools and convents such as the Anglo-Chinese School Acts, Methodist Girls' School MGS, Marymount Convent School, Convent of the Holy Infant Jesus CH Hij, Kenosis Convent located in Aljunied. However, as decolonization occurred, many expatriate English returned to Britain, hence, in an unregulated socio-linguistic environment, the spontaneous varieties of a creolized English began to form after the 1960s in the East Coast. The teaching professions, especially teaching English, was a popular option in the European, Eurasian, Peranakan and Chinese communities who descended from privileged colonial civil service families for the Queen's Crown. From the beginning of the last century up till the 1970s. From the 1970s onwards, the permanent decolonization meant that the original Queen's English taught began to experience deformation and modification from other languages as a result. Whole generations of school children in the Siglap, Katong districts were taught English with an English ed, modified Queen's English accent minimally influenced by Eurasian, Peranakan and Hokkien Chinese intonation. Their Siglap, Katong accent, though not a pure form of Queen's English, is considered to be the prestigious variant of English in Singapore because that area has also tended to supply the ruling and civil service classes. Many uneducated immigrant Chinese, native Malay and Indian New Tamil immigrants who are trapped in the lower rungs of the social scale, often mock and ridicule this unmodern and foreign-sounding English. With the rise of the consumerist and mass middle class, second-generation immigrants of humble origins have begun to deliberately deform taught acrolectal English for street pigeon patois is a form of identity creation, self-actualization and self-determination. Prominent members of society still speak the acrolectal Queen's English in formal situations, including Benjamin Shears, David Marshall, Harry Lee Kuan Yew, Lee Soo Chow, Francis Seo and other affluent descendants of the East Coast communities. However, after 1965, with colonial attitudes being unpopular politically, a new culture-free English was promoted through the usages of television presenters in the former SBC Singapore Broadcasting Corporation, through to its renaming as TCS Television Corporation of Singapore and to the current MediaCorp. This post-1965 accent is sometimes known as the Channel 5 accent, so named after the English channel owned by the State Media Group. Citation needed. This gave rise to a new standard of artificially constructed but standardized acrolectal English for Singapore that did not equate to received pronunciation in Britain but corresponded to the latter's social function and status within the new Singaporean national context due to state monopoly, censorship and control over media in this early stage of Singaporean national politics. Despite this, the more affluent English-educated classes continued to support the original Christian missionary and convent schools financially to stem the degradation of English language instruction. Despite all attempts, the English language in Singapore began to naturally creolize. The post-1965 English-educated accent is hence different from that of the pre-1965 English ed accent. For example, PM Lee Hsien Loong and Lee Hsien Yong, sons of the political figure Lee Kuan Yew, do not speak their father's Queen's English. The pure English diphthongs in words like home, the liaison in pronunciation of r at the end of words ending with r followed by a word beginning with a vowel such as ever-emerging, pronounced in Queen's English as ever-emerging, does not occur. Instead, diphthongs are converted into simplified vowels, and elements of Chinese, Malay and other accents and influences begin to exert itself on the evolving acrolect. Parallel to this, British economic, political and linguistic influence began to decline starkly throughout the world as colonies gained independence, such as India, while the United States of America rose as a superpower and American English largely took over as the international economic and cultural prestige variant. This change became more pervasive with the rise of Hollywood and American popular culture as such, even among the English-educated. Classes, the type and use of English shifted again as more affluent families, scholarship boards and charities sent the youth to boarding schools, colleges and universities in the United States over the United Kingdom. Many more Singaporeans then began to be born abroad to a jet-setting English ed class and descendants of the ex-civil service class for left for higher-paying education, legal and corporate positions in the United States, Canada, or the United Kingdom, and a huge middle-class segment to Australia and New Zealand. As such, the English educated class born after 1965 do not speak the Queen's English anymore, nor do they hold the Channel 5 accent as a standard, reverting between the prestige variant of the countries they received schooling in, and the bourgeois patois for familiarity. As such, the English accent in Singapore has become an international hybrid similar to that of affluent families in Hong Kong, Shanghai, Beijing, Taipei and Tokyo. When unemployment rose during the Asian financial crisis of 1997, Singlish came under official attack as undermining an economic competitiveness factor, English language fluency consonants. Dental alveolar postalveolar palatal velar glottal stops pb. gum. Than in other varieties of English, the distinction between L and R is not stable at the basilectal level, as evinced by TV personality Fua Chu Kang's oft-repeated refrain to use your brain, use your brain, and don pray pray, don't play play, i.e. don't fool around. One might note, however, that both these examples involve initial consonant clusters, BL and place, respectively, and conflation of L and R is found less often when they are not part of a cluster, L, at the end of a syllable, pronounced as a velarized dark L in British or American English, is often so velarized in Singlish that it approaches the close mid-back unrounded vowel, e.g. sale, L, also tends to be lost after the back vowels, O, U, and for some basilectal speakers, the central vowel, hence Paul equals pa, P, roll equals ro, ro, tool equals two, two, and for some, pearl equals per, P. Syllabic consonants never occur, hence taken and battle, never or when the final, L, is vocalized. Little and litter may be homophones. The glottal stop is inserted at the beginning of all words starting with a vowel, similar to German. As a result, final consonants do not experience liaison, i.e. run onto the next word. For example, run out of eggs would be run out to vegs in most dialects of English, e.g. in general American, but run out of eggs, e.g. in Singlish. This contributes to what some have described as the staccato effect of Singapore English replaces final plosive consonants of syllables in regular to fast-paced speed speech, especially stops. Goodwood Park becomes goo, woo, pa, you, woo, pee, and there may be a glottal stop at the end of words such as back and out, like in Cambodian, where a final g becomes a k, bad becomes bat with an unaspirated t in final position. The distinction between voiced and voiceless sounds. Egg and peg. The following describes a typical system some speakers may further merge, e, and other speakers, especially better educated ones, make a distinction between I and or and There is generally no distinction between the non-close front monophthongs, so pet and pat are pronounced the same, pt. At the acrolectal level, the merged vowel phonemes are distinguished to some extent, and for some speakers elements from American English are introduced, such as pre-consonantal pronouncing the r in bird, port, etc. This is caused by the popularity of American TV programming. Current estimates are that about 20% of university undergraduates sometimes use this American-style pre-consonantal when reading a passage monophthongs. Mapping between Singlish and British RP vowels, Singlish phoneme RP phonemes as in, I, meet, pit, e, day, before a voiced plosive leg, set, a. Map, hair, car pass father, bus, ah, before, l, mile. Mock, thought court. O, low, u, food, put, see below, bird, idea better, I, ah, my, o. Ah, mouth, I, boy, j. Here, W, tour, J, cure, IJ, ah, fire, OW. Ah, power, remains, in Singlish, except when followed by a voiced plosive, B, D, or per gram, in which case it becomes, E. Among some speakers however, this is not entirely predictable, as egg has a close vowel so it rhymes with vague while peg has an open vowel and rhymes with tag, and similarly for most speakers bed has a close vowel so it rhymes with made, while fed has a more open vowel the same vowel as in bad which vowel occurs in each word therefore appears in these cases not to be predictable, I, remains, I, in Singlish, except when followed by L, in which case it is the monophthong. Examples of words have idiosyncratic pronunciations, flower, FL, expected, FLW, equals flower, and their, DJ, expected, D, equals their flower, flower and their. There are therefore not homophones in Singlish. This also applies to Manglish in general. Singlish vowels are tensor. Vowels with no glide where other varieties of English have an unstressed, i.e. a reduced vowel, Singlish tends to use the full vowel based on orthography. This can be seen in words such as accept, case, example, ksample, purchase, tase, maintenance, maintenance, presentation, presenten, and so on. However, this does not mean that the reduced vowel never occurs, as about and again have. In their first syllable it seems that the letter a is often pronounced, but the letter o usually has a full vowel quality, especially in the con prefix control, consider, etc. There is a greater tendency to use a full vowel in a syllable which is closed off with a final consonant, so a full vowel is much more likely at the start of absorb, bzb, than afford, fd. In loanwords from Hokkien that contain nasal vowels, the nasalization is often kept. Prosody. One of the most prominent and noticeable features of Singlish is its unique intonation pattern, which is quite unlike British, American or Australian English, etc. For example, Singlish is syllable-timed compared to most traditional varieties of English, which are usually stress-timed. This in turn gives Singlish rather a staccato feel. There is a tendency to use a rise-fall tone to indicate special emphasis. A rise-fall tone can occur quite often on the final word of an utterance, for example on the word cycle in I will try to go to the park to cycle, without carrying any of the suggestive meaning associated with a rise-fall tone in British English. In fact, a rise-fall tone may be found on as many as 21% of declaratives, and this use of the tone can convey a sense of strong approval or disapproval. There is a lack of the de-accenting that is found in most dialects of English, e.g. British and American, so information that is repeated or predictable is still given full prominence. There is often an early booster at the start of an utterance, so an utterance like I think they are quite nice and interesting magazine may have a very high pitch occurring on the word think. Coxford Singlish Dictionary, a published book on Singlish. There may be greater movement over individual syllables in Singlish than in other varieties of English. This makes Singlish sound as if it has the tones of Chinese, especially when speakers sometimes maintain the original tones of words that are borrowed into Singlish from Chinese. Overall, the differences between the different ethnic communities in Singapore are most evident in the patterns of intonation. So for example, Malay Singaporeans often have the main pitch excursion later in an utterance than ethnically Chinese and Indian Singaporeans generally. These pronunciation patterns are thought to have increased the clarity of Singlish communications between pidgin-level speakers in often noisy environments, and these features were retained in creolization grammar. The grammar of Singlish has been heavily influenced by other languages in the region, such as Malay and Chinese, with some structures being identical to ones in Mandarin and other Chinese varieties. As a result, Singlish has acquired some unique features, especially at the basilectal level. Note that all of the features described below disappear at the acrolectal level, as people in formal situations tend to adjust their speech towards accepted norms found in other varieties of English. Topic prominence. Singlish is topic prominent. Like Chinese and Japanese, this means that Singlish sentences often begin with a topic or a known reference of the conversation, followed by a comment or new information compared to other varieties of English. The semantic relationship between topic and comment is not important. Moreover, nouns, verbs, adverbs, and even entire subject-verb-object phrases can all serve as the topic. This country weather very hot one. In constructions that appear to be missing a subject to a speaker of most other varieties of English, and so-called pro-drop utterances may be regarded as a diagnostic feature of Singapore colloquial English or Singlish, for example, no good law. Such as many or for many nouns which seem logically to refer to a countable item are used in the plural, including furniture and clothing. Examples of this usage from corpus recordings are, so I bought a lot of furnitures from IKEA. Where are all the stuffs I ordered? I had to borrow some winter clothings. To be the copula, which is the verb to be in most varieties of English, is treated somewhat differently in Singlish. When occurring with an adjective or adjective phrase, the verb to be tends to be omitted. I damn naughty sometimes, an adverb such as very occurs, and this is reminiscent of Chinese usage of the word hen hen 2 or how how 3. This house very nice. It is also common for the verb to be omitted before the present participle of the verb. I still finding how come you so late still playing music, are you looking for trouble, is it slightly less common as the dropping out of to be when used as an equative between two nouns, or as a locative, dat one his wife law that lady is his wife. This boy the class monitor equals a subset of the disciplinary system. A monitor is empowered to enforce discipline by being an informant in the absence of the teacher or superior authority figure, but his, her authority is restricted to the class. This is unlike a prefect whose authority is house-wide or even school-wide. His house in Ang Mo Kyo in general, to be, drops out more after nouns and pronouns except I, he, and she, and much less after a clause what I think is or a demonstrative. This is past tense. Past tense marking is optional in Singlish. Marking of the past tense occurs most often in irregular verbs, as well as verbs where the past tense suffix is pronounced d. For example, I went to Orchard Road yesterday. He accepted in the end due to consonant cluster simplification. The past tense is most often unmarked when it is pronounced as t or d at the end of a consonant cluster. He talked so long, never stop. I ask him also never. The past tense is more likely to be marked if the verb describes an isolated event. It is a punctual verb, and it tends to be unmarked if the verb in question represents an action that goes on for an extended period. When I was young, I go to school every day. When he was in school, he always get good marks. One last night I mug so much, so Sean already to mug is to cram for an examination. Sean is an adjective for bored, tired. There seems also to be a tendency to avoid use of the past tense to refer to someone who is still alive. The tour guide speak Mandarin. Note in the final example that although the speaker is narrating a story, she probably uses the present tense in the belief that the tour guide is probably still alive. Change of state instead of the past tense. A change of state can be expressed by adding already or liao. Li Yu, to the end of the sentence, analogous to Chinese Lila. This is not the same as the past tense, but more of an aspect, as it does not cover past habitual or continuous occurrences, and it refers to a real or hypothetical change of state in the past, present or future. The frequent use of already pronounced more like already and sometimes spelt that way in Singapore English is probably a direct influence of the Hokkien Liao particle. For example, I cannot wait any more, must go already. Oh dear, I cannot wait any longer. I must leave immediately. Yesterday, they go there already. They already went there yesterday. Ah Song Kana Sai already. Then how if Ah Song were to get in trouble, what would you do? Kana is a phonetical mispronunciation of Kena by non-Malay speakers, which is itself a Malay word that may mean either to have encountered something or to have to do something. Notes further below. Sai is a Hokkien word that means feces, and figuratively it means trouble. So Kana Sai means touched by trouble or get into trouble. Some examples of the direct use of the Hokkien particle are: he throw liao. He has already thrown it away. I eat liao. I ate or I have eaten this new game. You play liao or not. As for this new game, have you played it yet? Negation. Negation works in general like English, with not added after to be, to have, or modals, and don't before all other verbs. Contractions can't, shouldn't are used alongside their uncontracted forms. However, due to final cluster simplification, the T drops out from negative forms, and N may also drop out after nasalizing the previous vowel. This makes nasalization the only mark of the negative I do, don't want. Form, how come today you never equals didn't hand in homework, how come he never equals didn't pay just now interrogative in addition to the usual way of forming yes-no questions. Singlish uses two more constructions, in a construction similar but not identical to Chinese a not a, or not is appended to the end of sentences to form yes-no questions or not cannot be used with sentences already in the negative, you want this book or not.